Hi everyone, welcome to this houdiniPill. I'm Javier Toledo from Brush VFX, and today we are going to learn about Julia sets. So first of all, let's define what a Julia set is. This here is the complex plane. This is the real axis, and this is the imaginary axis. Okay, so this plane here, every point in this plane represents a complex number with a real component and an imaginary component. And these numbers, for example, C equals A plus BI. A being the real part and B being the imaginary part. Okay? So to see if a point is in the Julia set or is it not in the Julia set, okay, we need to check for this equation here. Okay, so how does this work? C is going to be an arbitrary complex number. We're going to define it, okay, A plus BI. This is going to be C, our number. And Z is going to be the position of this plane. Well, let's call this Z prime, and this is going to be, this Z here is going to be our position. So we are going to square it and add our number. So the new position will be somewhere, for example, around here. And then we iterate it again. So for example, the new point moves around here. And again, so it moves here, and here, and here, and here, and here. And after a few iterations, we need to check if this point is inside a radius of 2, or if it's outside. So if it's inside, it will be in the Julia set, and if it's outside, it won't be in the Julia set. Okay, so this is quite similar to the Mandelbrot set, but in the Mandelbrot set, this C here, instead of being an arbitrary number, it will be the initial position of the point, okay? So let's go to Houdini and see how we can implement this thing. Okay, so here we are in Houdini. So let's create a grid that will represent our complex plane. Let's jump to top view. And since all the Julia set will be inside a radius of 2, let's make this 4x4. Okay, and let's increment this like 350 and 350. Okay, and let's lay down a point wrangle that will contain all the calculations. Okay, so first of all, let's define our main components here. So we'll define A and B as every position in the complex plane. So A will be position in the x axis, okay, and B will be the negative position in the Z axis, because as you can see, this is upside down, and for us, up is positive and down is negative. So B is negative PZ. Okay? So this is our point positions to complex number components. Okay, so next we need to define our complex number C. So this will be float CA and CB, being A the real part and B the imaginary part. So let's say, for example, CA, let's start with 0.5 and CB minus 0.3, for example. Then we will modify these numbers, okay? Okay, so now we need to start with a loop. Iterate over this function again and again, so we get new positions every time and we can check if it's inside or outside the Julia set. So let's start here our loop. Okay. So first we need to define the iteration we are in, so we can keep track of how many iterations it took to the point to escape or to get inside this two radius. So it will be zero. And then we need to define how many iterations we are gonna make. So let's call it max iter. And let's have a control here. Okay, so that will be, for example, 64. Okay. So we need to define a new position after each iteration, okay? So this will be new A and new B. And let's create the loop. It's gonna be a while loop, and it will be while our iteration is less than the max iteration that we defined earlier, we will execute this code. So let's jump to Photoshop and make this. Okay, so we need to first of all square this number. So we have A plus BI, and we need to square it. Okay, so this is A squared plus BI squared plus 2ABI. Since I is the square root of negative 1, if we square it, it will be minus 1. So this will be A squared minus B squared, because I squared will be minus 1, so we negate this, plus 2ABI. Okay, so this is this. And after squaring it, we need to add C. And C is our CA and CBI, because this is that component here. So plus CA plus CBI. So we need to group here the imaginary parts and the complex parts. So the imaginary parts and the real parts, sorry. So this is going to be A squared minus B squared plus CA. This will be the real part. And now let's say the imaginary part. So it's going to be 2AB plus CB. Okay, because this is all the parts that contain I. So let's make this. Okay, so let's jump to Houdini And let's see. So the new a will be a squared minus b squared plus c a. And the new b is going to be 2 times a times b plus c b. Okay. And after we do this, we need to update our position. So next iteration, we start from this new position. So a will be new a, and b will be new b. And after we do this, we increment the iteration number by 1. Okay, now we need to check if this new position is 2 units away from the origin. How are we gonna do this? Well, we can create a new vector. Let's call it pos. And it's gonna be set a 0 b. So we get this new vector. And we can check if the length of this vector is bigger than 2. And if that happens, we will break the loop. Okay. And we close here the loop. So let's do this. Okay, everything's working. Okay, so now everything here is completely white, so we need to give this thing some colors. So how are we gonna do this? We're gonna take into account how many iterations it took to escape or to get bounded inside of the set. So, and we are gonna use this to drive the hue of the colors. So let's create a new vector called HSV color. And this is gonna be a 3 vector with hue, saturation and value. And saturation and value are gonna be 1. So if we make a vector here, and it's gonna be these 3 components here, this one and this one will be 1. And this one is what we need to modify. So we're gonna fit here the iteration number for each point from no iterations to the max iteration. And we're gonna remap this from 0 to 1. Okay. And everything's working. So now we need to convert this HSV to RGB. So let's see. Our CD will be equal HSV to RGB HSV color. So, yeah, we get something. This is working, okay? So this is our Julia set, and now let's see what we can do with this. We can change these numbers by hand, or we can make it more controllable. Let's jump here to the Wikipedia, and let's see some of these Julia sets. Let's find, for example, this one. This one, the 2 numbers are minus 0.8 and 0.156. So let's see if this is working. Minus 0.8. Yeah, as you can see, this is a nice match. So let's increase this, for example, to 150. And we get more and more definition here. And if we increase this one, we get also more and more definition. Okay, so let's see how we can control this much better. Let's create here an external point that will have two components here. Okay, and let's plug this in here, and use these positions to move the number so we can have interactivity here. Okay, so how are we gonna do this? Okay, instead of typing these two by hand, let's create a vector here called external position, and it's gonna be the point attribute from input number one, point number zero, and our two components will be CA being external position.x, and CB will be external position.z. And as you can see here, when we move this point, we get all the different Julia sets with lots of control, and you can animate this and get different effects and transitions from one Julia set to another. And once this is done, you can use this to drive attributes that will extrude or copy things, as you saw in the intro of this video. So you can get really nice effects, and it's quite easy to do. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and hope to see you in the next one. Thank you, bye bye.